from slavery come back, that we are nothing. We are niggers. We are Negroes, colored, right? Why is it our nationality keeps changing every couple of years? We were supposed to be the ruling class on the earth. We are the Mosaic's chosen people. Read that again.
We the strongest.
That's right.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 1. And it shall come to pass, if thou shalt hearken diligently unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe and to do all his commandments.
So we have to do all the commandments. And we are here to show you that the commandments is still alive and well. We must come back to it and keep the commandments in the faith of Jesus Christ, the black Messiah. Read.
Which I command thee this day, that the Lord thy God will set thee on high above all nations of the earth.
Read on.
And all these blessings shall come upon thee, shall come on thee, and overtake thee.
Read.
If thou shalt hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
So that was the stipulation. If you shall hearken. Hearkens means to listen, right? If you listen, the Messiah is going to bless us, right? Jump down to, you shall be the head of, and not the king. Around me.
Verse 13. And the Lord shall make thee the head and not the tail.
So that is was the promise. If we kept the Mosaic commandment, we are going to be the head. Meaning, ruling this earth and not the tail, not below. Now we are in the bottom of society. We were never supposed to be in this condition. We were always supposed to be on top. Read it again.
And thou shalt make thee the head and not the tail.
Read.
And thou shalt be above only, and thou shalt not be beneath.
We shall be what? Above what?
And thou shalt be above only, and thou shalt not be beneath.
Read on.
If that thou hearken unto the commandments of the Lord thy God, which I command thee this day, to observe and to do them.
So that is all we had to do. But clearly our forefathers, when they came out of Egypt, when he delivered them from slavery, had bondage, clearly they did not listen when Moses gave them the commandment. Because look at us today. We are still living a curse that was placed upon them, which was slavery. And we're going to show you clearly that slavery is recorded in the Holy Bible. It was a prophecy that Moses gave almost 3,000 years ago, and it came to pass. Right? So jump to verse 15 now. Let's go through the curses to identify who the children of Israel are in these last days.
Deuteronomy chapter 28. Verse 15.
Wait, hold on. Give me Genesis 49 verse 1 and 2 first. Because I made a statement. I say the curses here was to identify who the children of Israel are in these last days. So let's go back to Genesis. Because Jacob told his son something. He told him, come, let me tell you what's going to happen to you in the last days. Showing it is future prophecy. Genesis?
Genesis chapter 49 verse 1. And Jacob called unto his sons and said, gather yourself together, that I may tell you that which shall befall you in the last days.
In the when?
In the last days.
So Jacob already knew the prophecy. He tell them, come together, let me tell you what's going to happen. You have to obey the Mosaic. All the commandments, read.
And his statutes, which I command thee this day.
Read on.
That all these curses.
All these what?
All these curses.
And we all know a curse is not a good thing. A curse is something bad that we don't want. Read.
Shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
Right. So give me verse 32.
Verse 32. Thy sons.
So now we're going to go into history. We were taught history in school, the slave trade. So let's line up history with the Bible and see if it lines up perfectly. And who it lines up with, right? Because it's only, the Bible prophesied only one group of people, one race, as an entire race was going to go into slavery over a period of time. So let's line up history with the Bible and see who these people are that was prophesied to go into slavery with slave ships, their sons and daughters taken away and sold as slaves, right? So let's get that.
Deuteronomy chapter 28 verse 32. Thy sons and thy daughter shall be given unto another people.
And thy sons and daughter shall be what?
Given unto another people.
So let's examine this issue. What race of people's children was taken away violently and given to another race of people? That only happened to us. The blacks, Hispanics, and Native American Indians. Right? So read on.
Thy sons and thy daughters shall be given unto another people, and thy eyes shall look and fail with longing for them all day long.
Read.
And there shall be no might in thy hand.
So when our poor parents' children was taken away and sold as slaves, they didn't have any power to get them back. They had no military might, no economic might, right? They cried. The orphan mothers cried for the children because you know women love their children. They was taken away and sold to this master on this plantation and that one on the next, right? So they had no power. This is actually showing that we are the children of Israel based on the curses. Verse 44, 41, just to strengthen that point.
Verse 41. Uh-huh. Thou shalt beget sons and daughters.
So we're going to make children, sons and daughters, read.
But thou shalt not enjoy them.
But we're not going to enjoy our children, why?
For they shall go into captivity.
They shall what?
They shall go into captivity.
So captivity, another word for captivity is bondage or slavery. So the Bible is telling you, a race of people is going to have their kids and they are going to not enjoy them because they were going to go into slavery. When you examine history, as soon as the child could walk and could move, they took that child and put him in the fields to work from sun up to sundown. If you look, examine history, there is records of children that died because of the hard labor, right? When you look at some of the graves, well, this is some of the history that they hide from us to not let us know that we are the people of this book. This book is identifying clearly who the children of Israel are based on the curses of Deuteronomy 28. We cannot deny history and we cannot deny the prophecies. It all lines up with us, right? So read it over again.
Verse 41. Uh-huh. Thou shalt beget sons and daughters.
Read.
But thou shalt not enjoy them. Uh-huh. For they shall go into captivity.
So all of your parents, their children went into slavery. They had no power to do anything about it. Why? Because you broke the Mosaic commandment. Because the Mosaic is a man that once he says something, he has to do it. He tell them, listen, if you keep my commandments, I'm going to set you above everybody. If you break it, you're going into slavery. But they didn't believe. But when it happened, that's when they started crying. But he said, I'm not going to help you because you are disobedient. But in these last days, we are here to show you that there is hope. Once you humble belong to this world and obey the Mosaic commandment, come back and keep the commandments in the faith of his son, Jesus the Christ, you have hope. You have redemption, right? So this is what we heard our message to you people. That there is hope. There is salvation in Christ, right? So we're going to go through all of that. But we're going to finish up some of the curses here. Give me verse 37.
Verse 37.
Uh-huh.
And thou shalt become an astonishment.
So we were astonished because we wondered, well, how are we in these conditions today? Read.
A proverb.
A proverb. Right. So that's a wise saying. Because they say anything you want to hide from a nigga, put it where? In a book. That's a proverb, a wise saying. Read.
And a byword.
A byword is any other name outside your God-given name. The Mosaic called us Judah, Benjamin, and Levi. During slavery, we were called American blacks, West Indian blacks, Haitians, Trinidadians, Grenadians, right? So they put bywords upon us. Why? Because they don't want you to know that you are the greatest people on earth, that you are the children of Israel.
Bring it up.
Right? The children of the Most High God. You are the chosen people. And we're here to prove that undeniably with the scriptures. Anything we say, we're going to prove it out of the scriptures. Read it again.
And thou shalt become an astonishment,
uh-huh,
a proverb,
uh-huh,
and a byword,
read,
among all nations, whether the Lord shall lead thee.
And we were scattered through the four corners of the earth, all over this earth. We were scattered with cargo slave ships, right? We were put into hard bondage. Read.
Verse 38.
Yeah.
Thou shalt carry much seeds out,
read,
into the field,
uh-huh,
and thou shalt gather but little.
Yes, because we were harder in. So we had to slave. In the cotton field, in the sugarcane field, in all these fields during slavery. All of her parents didn't have a rest, sun up to sundown. They were in the fields, working, and bringing in little, because they got the scraps. That is no way for people to live. Even today, we struggle to make ends meet, paycheck to paycheck. We work the hardest on this earth, but it seems like we can get nowhere. Still living paycheck, still can afford to take a vacation and relax. Why? Because we have to work. Because if we don't work, we don't get money. We cannot take care of our family. The hardest working people see the most trouble. And nobody sees a problem with that. Something has to be wrong. That is the curses that the Most High put on all people because our foreparents rebelled against his commandment.
That's
but
right.
All we have to do is stop rebelling. Accept that you are the chosen people, the Israelites, and that you must come back to the Most High. He gave only us, our foreparents, the last statutes and commandments. That is a special thing, right? Read.
Verse 38.
Uh-huh.
Thou shalt carry much seed out, uh-huh, into the field, and shall gather but little, for the locusts shall consume it.
And that is what happened. Most time you plant and you can see your produce. That is all curses. Jump to verse 41. How about a stranger?
Verse 41.
41. Yeah.
Verse 43. The stranger that is within thee shall get up above thee very high.
So the strangers, those people that came out in Egypt, that was the strangers that was in and amongst us. The Most High said, listen, if you don't listen to me, those same people that I chose to be your servants, they are going to get up above you. Read it over.
The strangers that is within thee shall get up above thee very high.
Really?
And thou shalt come down very low.
When he say come down very low, we are going to be the bottom of society. All other race is going to be above us. And it's clear today, we see that the Arabs, the Chinese, the Caucasian, all of them is above us today. Right? Ruling. Right? We have to go to them. The IMF, the World Bank. We have to go to them and lend at high interest, and we cannot pay it back. Right? Right? So that's telling you that if we don't listen, the strangers is going to get up above us, and they're going to be ruling over us, right? And feeding us crumbs when we're the hardest working people. Read.
Hosea chapter 8, verse 8. Israel is swallowed up. Now shall they be among the Gentiles.
So we are scattered among the Gentiles, the other nations, read.
As a vessel wherein is no pleasure.
And nobody desires us. We are the most hated people on this earth. And nobody seems to know why. Why? Because you are the chosen people. All the promises belong to you. And these other nations know that. They have all the histories going back thousands of years. And they know who you are. So that is why they hate you. Because why? You are God's chosen people. And they are not. Read. Read it over.
Deuteronomy?
Yeah, 28.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 43. The stranger that is within thee shall get up above thee very high.
Read.
And thou shall come down very low. He shall lend to thee.
And it's obvious, these other nations, the IMF, the World Bank, they are lending money to us. We are beggars, begging them for crumbs. At high interest that they know we cannot afford to pay back. And when you default on the loan, what happens? They take over your assets. That is what's going on all over the world. Look at Libya and all these places. And Venezuela. Right now, Venezuela, our brothers down in Venezuela, America put sanctions on them. Right? Why? All because they want the oil. Very covetous. And they're destroying millions of people. People are hungry there. But that is the cause, is because these Venezuelans, so-called Venezuelans, are Israelites as well. They didn't escape the curses. Northern Kingdom didn't escape the curses. The Most High said, each and every one of us is going to go through that. Right? So they shall what? Lend to what?
He shall lend to thee.
So the other nation is going to lend to us.
And thou shalt not lend to him.
And we cannot lend to them. Why? Because we are in an impoverished state, at the bottom of society, begging these other nations for crumbs, which was supposed to be ours, if we only obeyed the Mosaic commandments. Read.
He shall be the head.
And they are ruling over us.
And thou shalt be the tail.
And we have to answer to them. Look at that, the Queen of England. Right? And people say we're independent. Just the other day, the nation celebrated independence. Independence from what? You still have people ruling over you. You still have the Queen. Why is her face on your money? Think about that. If you're free, why is another race of people their face on your money? No, it's an illusion. You're still a slave to the system. We have to slave and pay all these taxes to them, and they sit down in the palace and they're collecting all that money. They don't have to do nothing. Think about it. You slaving and working 9 to 5, 2-3 jobs, and all your money is going to taxes to the Queen of England. That's why they call it Crown Lands. Who the land belongs to? The Crown, Her Majesty's prison. You're free, but your prison, the name of your prison belongs to the Queen, but you're just so free. It is all an illusion, people. It's time for people to wake up and understand that your leaders is just set up to keep you in a delusion, always hoping promises that will never come to pass. All foolishness. Time to wake up. Come back to your true nationality as the Israelite. That's and right. Repent as the Israelites. That is the only way we're going to get out of these conditions, by returning back onto the Most High. There's no other way. Christianity is not going to save you. Islam is not going to save you. The only thing that's going to save you is the Messiah, through Christ, the black Messiah. Right? So, you have anything else to read?
Verse 45. Moreover, all these curses shall come upon thee,
really?
And shall pursue thee.
So, no matter how we try to run from poverty, the Bible said these curses is going to pursue us, really?
And overtake thee.
And it's going to take us over. We leave here and go to the States, same thing. You might be a little better, but you're still a slave to the system. Really?
Till thou be destroyed.
And we were destroyed mentally. And still destroyed to this day in these false religion, doctrines and philosophies. But we have to shake off all that. Read.
Because thou hearkenest not unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
Uh-huh.
To keep his commandments.
Read.
And his statutes.
Read on.
Which he command thee. And there shall be upon thee for a sign.
For what?
For a sign.
Right. So what does a sign do? A sign is something to identify something. If we want to know where Scotiabank is, what we have to do? We look for the sign Scotiabank. So we know Scotiabank is right there. Same as KFC, Digicel. So the Bible is saying, these curses is going to be on a particular group of people for a sign to identify, hey, you are the children of Israel. You are the children of the Most High. Based on these curses, which is slavery. That didn't happen to anybody else. No other race could claim that they went through 400 years of hard bondage. Yokes are bound on the neck. That happened to one people, so it says what? They are going to be what? These curses is going to be on us for what?
Moreover, all these curses shall come upon thee,
uh-huh.
shall pursue thee,
read.
And overtake thee,
mm-hmm.
till thou be destroyed,
read.
Because thou hearkenest not unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to keep his commandments and his statutes which he command thee.
Read.
And they shall be upon thee for a sign.
So the curses is going to be on the children of Israel for a sign to identify them. Read.
And for a wonder.
This is what he's saying is we're talking about Queen Yellow Christianity. So let's address if what the Bible says, if it's racist or if God is racist or not.
Alright, so let's get that. Because the Most High is the one that chose a particular group of people. Give me Deuteronomy 7 and 6. Let's see if God is racist or not.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 7, verse 6.
So sister, listen and see if God is racist. Because when you choose one group of people, that is prejudice there already. So let's see if there's equality in the Bible. Read.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 7, verse 6.
Uh-huh.
For thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God.
So the Moses said to a particular group of people, you are a holy people unto me. Read.
The Lord thy God had chosen thee.
Has what?
Chosen thee.
Uh-huh.
To be a special people.
Read on.
Unto himself.
Uh-huh.
Above all people that are upon the face of
no,
the
no,
Lord.
No, brother. The sister said, equal to all people.
Above all people that are upon the face of the earth.
So sister, the Messiah said he chose one group of people to be above all other people on the face of the earth. That is racist. Give me Deuteronomy 32, verse 8.
The 9.
Because the Messiah is always about separation. There is no equality in this Bible. Where we get this foolishness? Equality came with the so-called slave master. At the same time, he's telling you, we are all equal. You are two-fifths of a man in slavery. He was raping, robbing, and murdering you. But he's telling you, we are one in Jesus. But we were not even a whole man to him. Give me that, Deuteronomy 32.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 32, verse 9.
So let's see if God says, all nations come together as one. Read.
For the Lord's portion is his...
No, jump up.
Verse 8.
Yeah.
When the Most High divided the nation...
No. When the Most High bring all races together.
When the Most High divided to the nations their inheritance...
So the Most High is the one that separated all races. That is why he made the Chinese, they look alike. The Caucasians look alike. The Israelites look alike. Right? He wanted to have a distinction between the races. The Most High created different races, not us. And he was the one to separate and divide. So there is no such thing as equality in the scriptures. The Most High is a racist because he chose one people and he rejected everybody else. That is God. If you have a problem with that, when you meet him on that day, if you can speak, you can go and get it. But read it.
when the Most High divided the nations, their inheritance, when he separated the sons of Adam.
So God separated the sons of Adam. Everybody comes from Adam, yes. But he separated them, read.
He set the bounds of the people according to the number of the children of Israel.
Read on.
For the Lord's portion is his people.
No, the Lord's portion is everybody.
Is his people.
No, brother. Everybody is one in Jesus.
For the Lord's portion is his people. Jacob is the Lord of his inheritance.
So who am I? Who am I to argue against the Messiah who created everything? The boss said his inheritance is his people. His is a possessive word. The Messiah chose one group of people and he rejected everybody else.
All you have to do is the tremor of God.
It's so hard to serve God. And why would I say that I'm a Jew? It's so odd. For years I've been walking around saying that I'm a black man. I ain't saying that no more. It's so wrong, man.
This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us. Subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. More information, please visit www.israelunite.org.